is a schoolboy football. Run, come, look one, look on. Which team are the best and I go better than the rest? And if I hear team beat your chest, is a schoolboy football. A team could rise and a team could fall, but they never will know until the whistle blows. So run, come, enjoy the show. Is a schoolboy football.
After starting with more than 50 schools, we are down to the final 32. The business end of Issa Schoolboy Football is upon us. And at the end of 90 minutes, we shall say goodbye to one more team. It will be an all-out battle for survival. The Acosta Cup continues on your home of champions with this second round, second leg clash between Glenmuir High and Morant Bay live from Maypen in Clarendon. Well, the weather stands at 27 degrees Celsius, of course, a pretty cool day with humidity at 90%. It was a little bit of rain, but of course, we are good for today's encounter. The 2023-2022 Ben Francis Cup winners, Glenmuir High, taking an advantage into this game, 3-0 against a team that, of course, will be happy that they've been able to make it back here for the first time. Morant Bay, they now have a different task. Can they overturn this deficit? That's the question that they'll be asking themselves. But of course, they made it here for the first time in 5 years, and they shall be a little bit happy about that. That is how I welcome you to here, Glenmuir High School. Of course, Maypen Clarendon, and of course, football is its best in this parish. We love it. Look at the field, look at the surroundings. Absolutely marvelous. And I'm looking forward to see how the game goes today. Of course, Glenmuir High, 3-0 advantage in the first leg, coming into the second leg, a home fixture for them against Morant Bay High, who have a lot of work to do in order to ensure that they can go forward. But before we get to the game, before we look at all of the things that we can look at, of course, I'm thanking you for joining us on Sportsmax CVM and on the Sportsmax app, because of course, if you want to watch all of the live action that we have throughout the season in Trinidad and Tobago as well as here in Jamaica, just download the Sportsmax app, go to the Google Play Store or the App Store, tell a friend, tell your family that they don't want to miss a minute of this. Well, let's hear now from both of the coaches, starting with the coach of Glenmuir High, Andrew Peart. Coach Peart, you have a 3-0 advantage coming into this game. Were you happy with the way your team played in the first leg? And are there any changes that you would like to see?
Yeah, we were fairly pleased with the output displayed in the first leg. 3-0 advantage coming to the second leg. It's always good. At this stage of the competition, the key aim is to ensure that they're in the round of 16. I think 3 goals could be more, but that's just football. The pros are scoring like 1 in every 3 or 4 chances. So we are fairly satisfied. We have another leg of 90 minutes here to prove ourselves that we deserve to take our next step further.
Yeah, you have a couple of players coming back from injury, of course, one with a broken hand. How are they fitting back into the system?
Oren Watson, yes, coming from a dislocated wrist. He still not fully fit as yet. So we are just biding our time with him.
Yeah, but you only suffered one defeat thus far. It's good to see that that hasn't really put any stumbling blocks in front of you.
Yeah, a little bit of it is that sometimes you need to face a little bit of adversity. Not that you intend or wish for it to happen, but it happened and then we learned from it. So we never lost, we only learn. So that's an important attitude to have from here on.
Coach Brown, you have to try to come from behind to win this game here today against Glenmuir High. Just exactly what went wrong in the first game, what would you need to get corrected in order to win this game?
The team is a young team and we made some simple mistakes. So the thing is that now we organize, we get back and we organize, and I know this time we'll do much better.
Yeah, you got a chance to play against Glenmuir High. Yeah. What are some of the things that you learned about them that you can use to your advantage coming into this second leg?
Yeah, they had fast players up front, and they had a midfield where they well organized in the midfield. So we, you know, go to training, we go train, and we are going to do better.
Yeah, let me ask you though, despite what happens here today, win or lose, you've been able to get Morant Bay out of the group for the first time in 5 years. Do you see that as a successful season for you?
Yeah. Yeah, this is a success. We have a three-year program, so we were expecting to come out of the zone this year. So I know that next year we are going to do better.
So there you go. Both coaches, the task is clear for each of them. Glenmuir High, just to finish off what they started, of course, in this game. But for Morant Bay, is to try to overturn the deficit. But if they don't, they're satisfied with how they've come out this season. So let's not wait any longer. Let's go upstairs to our commentator, Dean Smith. He has all the action for you. Don't go anywhere.
Thank you so much, Gerard Morris-Seeley. Yes, it's a quick look at the first leg results from the second round of the Da Costa Cup. Stets, of course, beating Irving 1-0. BB Cook 2-0 winners over Paul Bogle. Glenmuir 3-0 over Morant Bay. Stalemate between Tacky and Cedric Titus. Ocherius lost to Happy Grove 2-1. Clarendon College mauled De Carteret 8-0. Gata Masaya, they hammered St. Mary High 7-0. Cornwall 3-1 over Black River. William Nib, they had a stalemate. They'll do battle tomorrow. Christiana beating Recise. That was perhaps a surprise of the second round. 3-0. Bellier, 1-0 between themselves and Mile Gully. Port Antonio beating Mannings. Surprisingly, 1-0. Froome, 4-1 over Veer. Manchester, 1-0 over Monroe. McGraw, 1-0 over Edwin Allen. And Dintil over Horace Clark, 2-0. Those are the second round first leg results. We welcome you to Glenmuir Road in the parish of Clarendon for this second leg of the second round. Glenmuir hosts Morant Bay, already having a 3-goal cushion to their credit. They will renew rivalry and seek to progress to the quarterfinal groupings. For Morant Bay, there's solace in the fact that they would have made it thus far as part of their program. But can they pull back what would be perhaps the most spectacular of recoveries in schoolboy football in history? We pause for the national anthem of Jamaica. Yes, that music always gives goosebumps to all those who appreciate the words and the music behind it. Morant Bay, they greet the referees as well as their counterparts, Glenmuir. Some amount of showers earlier, perhaps across Jamaica. Two captains now step forward. Javier Grant for Morant Bay and Kyle Gordon for Glenmuir. The referee, O'Shane Nation, assisted by Jermaine Yeesing and Mojali Gale. Fourth official, Alexi Perry. They have a coin toss to determine either the field or the ball. Glenmuir win the ball. Morant Bay, they decided to take the right side of the field from the commentary position. Here's a quick look at the lineup for Glenmuir. Antoine Gooden in goal. They have a defensive lineup of Ramon Francis, Jason White, Neumoni Blackwood, and Neil Headley. further up the field, DeAndre Johnson, Kyle Gordon, Arrell Miller, Tajon Cummins, Tavon Coleman, and Akeen Saunders. They're coached by Andrew Peart. Moran Bay, in goal they have Javier Grant, Jaheim Hall, Rashane Rowe, Antonio Goldburn, Darren Williams, Richard Golding, Nikoi Thompson, Jervin Miller, Jalen Thomas, Marcus Davis, Kevoy Gold, they're coached by Llewellyn Brown. Glenmuir in red and white, Moran Bay in green and white. Of course, Moran Bay being the past school of Olympic champion Hansa Parchment over the 110 meters hurdles, would have had other schools among his credits as well. But for all intents and purposes, his allegiance to the green and white. Referee O'Shea Nation getting himself warm and ready for what is expected to be another great showpiece of the Costa Cup football action in the parish of Clarendon, such an active parish, producing quality teams year on year. And yeah, normally when the teams progress from Clarendon, they do go further on in the competition. Interestingly, last year, Clarendon had finalists in all trophies on offer, perhaps the exception being the Champions Cup. But all the rural trophies on offer, yeah, Clarendon represented there. O'Shea Nation sends the whistle. Niamoni Blackwood in the center there, getting things ready for Glenmuir High School. Kyle Gordon tries to find Aurel Miller. Morant Bay alert to the danger, and they try to push it upfield. Trying to advance now through Nikoi Thompson, the five goal man. Still in possession is Morant Bay. Glenmuir in control. Cummings here. Quite a tricky one. Releases Gordon. Gordon goes direct. Ball kept in play. Lifted in the area once more. Header on. Early. Easy. Arrell Miller. Moran Bay in shock, in disbelief. Glenmuir in dreamland. And Arrell Miller continues their merry road. In just the second minute of play, already they pile on more pressure and more misery on Moran Bay. That ball from Kyle Gordon flashed across and it was returned. And the header on, bang on target. DeAndre Johnson with the assist there, Arrell Miller finishing it off. And now Arrell Miller moves from four goals to five goals this season. And it only is an uphill task if it was not won already for Morant Bay. Certainly last year they were one of the better playing teams in my estimation. Unfortunately, they just couldn't progress from the quarterfinal group. And speaking with some of the coaching staff, they mentioned that they had clear goal scoring opportunities, easy tap-ins, and it just wouldn't fall for them on that day. Of course, they would have lost or I think drawn with Edwin Allen, and when they needed a win to ensure they qualified for the semi-final round. So they had quality from last year. They would have lost a few of their key men, David Reed perhaps being key of them. That's the head coach for Glenmuir. Andrew Peart went to school at Manchester High School. He, along with Marlon Hilton of Port Antonio, talking about coaches here, and Miguel Coley, certainly of Jamaica College fame, would have all been inspired by Barry Watson, the current coach from Mile Gully. And he, Barry Watson, would have also brought Manchester High to the Da Costa Cup final in 2009. So he must have a great feeling of accomplishment, seeing so many of his charges, individuals whom he influenced, being themselves influencers for good in the game of football. Of course, Peart and Coley being among the top individuals along that line. Llewellyn Brown has been coaching for 30 plus years, the man behind Murad Bey's advance this season. They brought Seaforth High School to the last eight. We have been coaching Demar Phillips in that time. That's the early 2000s. And incidentally, it was Glenmuir who actually knocked them out at that stage of the competition. So he has hard memories of Glenmuir. Murad Bey trying to get themselves together, get a firm footing. You think that even a goal would be some measure of consolation for them. It's a throw in for them on the right hand side of the field. Glenmuir now in possession. Gordon there was bundled over. Blackwood giving away possession through a throw in, taken quickly by Murad Bey. And the offside flag raised. Keem Saunders there, the guilty party. Possession given away cheaply, and now Gordon on the charge. Good challenge that from Javier Grant to avert the danger. Cummins on the ball, so silky. Still Cummins, he loses possession now. But Glenmuir hustling to keep possession of the ball, getting a lot of the first balls, second balls as you'd call it. They've really clocked the midfield, has Glenmuir not giving a lot of breathing space to Murad Bey. Advancing now is DeAndre Johnson. He had a beautiful delivery. Obliges once more. And Ashe Nation points to the spot. It's a penalty for Glenmuir. And a yellow card as well, being dished out to Antonio Goldburn. Here's a replay. Aurel Miller really did well to get in front of Goldburn and the guilty party, clipping his foot on that occasion. And Glenmuir there in easy street, piling on pressure on Murad Bey. From a parish perspective, it's really David versus Goliath. I'll give you more on that. Kyle Gordon stepping up. He converts easily, showing his quality and his class. Kyle Gordon, only his third goal this season, but his contribution to the Glenmuir team, not restricted only to goal scoring, important in their build-up play and the cohesion of the midfield. And of course, the captain, having experience from last season, he was the man of the match in that Ben Francis Cup winning team. 2-0 for Glenmuir, 5-0 on aggregate. And yes, we're still in the 8th minute of play.
Go on to wide.
Another ball played through. Akeem Saunders there was trying to get on the end of it. DeAndre Johnson has been instrumental in all goals so far. Beautiful delivery. Gardner! It's really, really easy street today. 3-0 already in the 9th minute of play. I mentioned it was David versus Goliath. And he'd be hoping he has a sling. Ball played in and fired expertly from the half volley by Kyle Gordon, the captain. Yeah, that's how you finish. It's really been finishing school. Again, they come forward. He's offside this time, Kyle Gordon. He'll be eager for an hat-trick. And what a time for him to put on his goal-scoring boots, so to speak. 2 on the afternoon for the season thus far. Here comes Morant Bay. They're trying to advance. Morant Bay trying to advance. That should be easily handled by Antoine Gooden, the custodian for Glenmuir. Played out to Ramon Francis. DeAndre Johnson has been a menace on this, the right-hand flank. That delivery, though, hasn't been of the quality that we've seen of him, providing 2 assists so far. From a parish perspective, St. Thomas, they really haven't made any great inroads in senior schoolboy football, of course. Teams would have progressed to quarterfinal, perhaps semi-final rounds, but no winners from St. Thomas. I mean, it's all the talent that many of the Eastern schools perhaps individually have produced. Here's Cummins. What a move by him. Cummins! And the challenge there was really necessary at that time. Concedes a corner kick. But it's really been all Glenmuir in this, the first 10 minutes of this encounter, make that 11. Ranbe get to break now. Well, time challenge that by Glenmuir to avert the danger on that left-hand flank. Here's Glenmuir. The high line there off Morant Bay. Being able to bring some trouble to Glenmuir. Have been caught offside a few times. Three offsides to Glenmuir. They've really been pushing, trying to break the lines, but missing the timing on a few occasions. Morant Bay get to clear. Gordon on the ball for Glenmuir. Losing possession to Gold. Blackwood. Gordon. Jason White trying to release DeAndre Johnson. Advancing now is Akeem Saunders. Saunders tries to whip it across. Broken up by Morant Bay. but still in possession is Glenmuir. Francis. Wet underfield conditions now. That ball was intended for, looks to be Rashane Rowe, but beyond him. Cummings to Blackwood. That ball wasted. As is common, football is well supported in the parish of Clarendon. Randby getting a free kick there. As a light drizzle returns the compound here of Glenmuir High School. Blackwood guilty of the infraction on that occasion. Quarter of an hour they're about being played in this encounter. Glenmuir leading 6-0 on aggregate. Here's a kick straight to goal. Antoine Gooden able to hold on to that one effectively. Here's White, chasing White for Glenmuir. Too much on that one. Moon Francis unable to bring it under control. Went out for a throw-in. Glenmuir, though, having possession once more, but broken up by Golding. Still Golding. Golding in the area. Golding with a shot blocked. Warren Bay still trying to come forward.
Again, we are gone.
Glenmuir on the ball now. Gooden with the long ball forward, looking for Cummings. Goldberg punching that one back in the area. It's now with Thompson from Moran Bay. Thompson's trying to go in around his man. Broken up by Headley. Gives away a throw in, but nothing much in that one. Here comes the delivery now from Moran Bay. Broken up by Glenmuir, who can now break through Johnson. Johnson with the delivery to Aurel Miller. He'll try to connect with Cummings, or will he? Still Miller. Went into traffic. Some of the spectators on hand saying that poor decision making, selfish play from Aurel Miller. Had Cummings, could have played him to keep the pressure going. But here, Moran Bay, they try to respond. Looks to be Williams. He's been forced from the danger area, but he connects now to Rashane Rowe. Rowe released that shot quickly. Not troubling Antoine Gooden. But perhaps that's a spark he'll need to grow in confidence. That at least the deficit can be reduced to somewhat. Johnson on the ball for Glenmuir. White to Francis. Tavon Coleman there. Cummings. Silky player. Johnson was offside though. Headley on the ball. happy to keep possession deep in their own half. Glenmuir, that opens up space in the middle of the park, as we just saw. Now they're able to have the overload. Aurel Miller having quite a lot of time on the ball, but does make some mistakes with that. Here's Cummings. Blackwood doing well just to shield the ball from Darren Williams, who was intended target for that throw-in. Glenmuir, they now have a throw-in on the left-hand side. Lot on the mind of Llewellyn Brown. A lot on their minds as well. Headley to Coleman. Offside flag is up. Joachim Saunders. Colburn received the ball back from his captain Grant. Punts it upfield. Control was lacking from Thompson, keeping a possession to Glenmuir. Now able to utilize space easily in the middle of the park. They have a high line, does Morant Bay. Chanson now sends it across. Cummins on the end of it. Cummins! Easy does it. It doesn't get much easier than that. Javier Grant having a nightmare in goal. Morant Bay having a nightmare at Glenmuir Road. Tajon Cummins from 5 goals to 6 goals this season. And again on the right side, DeAndre Johnson. How instrumental has he been in giving pinpoint accurate passes? And look at the finish, cool and easy. And it's misery for Morant Bay in Clarendon. Good turn that from Blackwood. Here's Francis. Sent forward for Johnson. He looked to send one across. Saunders. Goldburn had to do well to play it out. It's a corner kick for Glenmuir. Headley there, showing the strength of his left foot. So, Gerard Morrisseely has a sideline report for us. Gerard, what's happening?
Thank you so much, Dean. Well, this one's coming from the Morant Bay side. A couple minutes ago, you saw every substitute on the bench up and warming up. Well, I went over there just to inquire about why that was so. And they told me that, well, it is a thing that they do, a ritual that they do every game that they're down early. Every substitute on the bench is asked to go on warm up. When I went to the coach, Coach Brown, he told me that he was thinking of making a few changes, but then the game seemingly got a little bit under control with the starting 11 that they have on the field. Moments ago, of course, another goal was added. but they didn't get back up. But however, this is something that he is considering. Every game that Morant Bay goes down early, he asks all of his substitutes to go on the bench. They're sitting now because he reconsidered his decision and decided against making those substitutes and, well, those substitutions. And yeah, Morant Bay 4-0 down. And of course, a lot of work for them to do. That's it from the sidelines for me.
Thank you so much, Gerard Morosili. I tell you what, only 7 substitutions in 4 windows in SRN competitions. So at least 4 players would remain on the park. But you would imagine that not even with 7 substitutions, they'd be able to get back from this deficit. Here's Rowe for Morant Bay. Trying to dance. Gives away possession cheaply. Grant there with a good pass forward. Rowe pushing forward. Thompson on the end of that one. Tavon Coleman doing well. Gives up the corner. But I'm sure they won't mind. Tajon Cummins' confirmation is 6th goal this season. The number 19 for Glenmure. Corner kick delivered in. Golding trying to connect. That time was with Davis, but that was broken up. Playing out now is Glenmure. Cummins doing well to get by. Miller and Johnson didn't see that intended pass forward. And credit to Morant Bay, they have stuck with their high line. And perhaps just to ensure that they remain in the systems. Here's Cummins. And that was a crucial intervention from Goldburn. Aaron Miller was there lurking. Thompson for Morant Bay. Rowe. Here's Rowe in the area. His shot is deflected. Morant Bay still advancing. And O'Shea Nation will have no choice but to flash out a yellow card. Nimone Blackwood there, the guilty man. So it's a free kick for Morant Bay. Can there be some magic for them? Delivered in the box. Over the target. So Glenmure in cruise control as we approach the half an hour mark in this encounter. Certainly, they look comfortable in possession. Morant Bay again, as you see in that shot, the very high line. All 5 defenders at the halfway line. Here's Johnson Miller will try to outrun Colburn. Colburn did well there. Throw in call goes the way of Barambe as well. Johnson, three assists for this man, Johnson, with Coleman. Blackwood will try to release Cummins. His timing was off. He's offside. Francis Johnson did well to release Saunders. Richard Golding stepped forward just in time to keep the trap active, the offside trap. Would love to see how Glenmuir would respond if Coach Brown from Ranby does a tactical change in bringing back his back line to a mid block or perhaps even a low block. Haven't really done that in the opening half an hour. That ball intercepted. Golding, under pressure from Johnson, has to give it away quickly for a throw in. Jason White under pressure from Marcus Davis. Here's Cummins. Offside once more. Well read by Blackwood. Trying to come forward is Moranbe through Thompson. Headley's there and does well to ease him off and punt it upfield. Kept in by Moranbe, but only to the advantage of Glenmuir. Captain releases Saunders now. Johnson not reading the line well, and Saunders alert to that particular problem. Brought it back. Here's Johnson. Perhaps the only missed kick I've seen from him all afternoon. Johnson comes again on possession. White, Francis, Coleman goes all the way back to Antoine Gooden in goal. Using square passes just to open up the middle of the field. Miller, that ball was poor. Imoni Blackwood, the guilty party again, and he'll get a talking to from the referee, already on a yellow card. Kyle Gordon telling him to keep his focus and his concentration. And perhaps only the mercy of the referee that says no, because this late challenge in other circumstances would have been a yellow card. Referee Nation showing some measure of grace and compassion, obviously, is Moranbe. That header only Amir Tees for the goalkeeper. Cummins on the ball. Does have a swagger about him when he's on the ball, to John Cummins. Called it to Thompson. Thompson tries to fire. Took a slight deflection. Went across the face of goal. Antoine Gooden collected easily. Glenmuir now pushing forward. That ball beautifully threaded through. And again, Antonio Goldburn, crucial in the defensive lineup for Moran Bay. Goldburn. Thomas. Ball given away to Miller. Miller! Took touch too much. Here's Cummins now. Williams trying the back heel. Gets the throw in, takes it quickly. Headley there. Gains possession for Glenmuir. Ball back to Headley. To Coleman. And RL Miller on that occasion, he was waiting for the flag. He had the feeling that he was offside. Substitution being made, Pneumonia Blackwood being brought off. Entering the game, Brandon Wallace. Another substitution being made, this time by Moran Bay. Marcus Davis coming off and entering the field. Javane Brown. Glenmuir, possession with Johnson. Well, he was the intended target there. And they giving away throw in. Headley. Gordon unable to latch onto that one. Jason White. Saunders. Still in possession. Headley finds White. Saunders will work with DeAndre Johnson, beating the trap on that occasion. Sends it across. R.L. Miller clearing the argy-bargy. Cummings. Oh, beautifully blocked by the keeper, Javier Grant. And Darren Williams trying to boot it upfield now. That's blocked, but what? A lot of action there at the front of goal. Cummings blocked by the brilliance of Javier Grant, who made himself big by going low. And I'm sure he saw goal number 7 all over that one. Here's Rowe, broken up quickly by Imran Bey. Cummings with a good touch, loses it though. Rowe again. Brandon Wallace on the ball now for Glenmuir. The triangulation has been good, Glenmuir. And look at that ball now that releases DeAndre Johnson, the 8-ball man. Johnson with the keeper. Well, you could call him a mailman. He delivers well. But when he's the finish, he is not the author and the finisher. That was horrible. And it's no insult to him. I judge him based on the quality of passes that I've seen from him. Here's Headley. Sunlight increasing. Glenmuir. Beautiful ball for Saunders by himself. Saunders, he did the chip, but he has to hold down his head, and I think he should be a bit more penitent. She's not proud of that one. He had so much options there, and to think he went wide. Here they come again. Johnson, Javier Grant has come alive. Ewelin Brown, no longer seated. Carl Gordon standing behind this corner kick for Glenmuir. Gordon with the in-swinger into the near post, but it comes back to Gordon. Did well in the half space. Gordon goes for goal, and the follow-up is good. The offside flag says it wasn't. He's been coached, the keeper, Javier Grant. I'm sure you hear it in the background as well. You have to laugh when you hear the football crazy fans with their periods of coaching by the sideline, or in the case of the goalkeeper, by the byline. You'll hear a lot of coaching in the background. I'm hearing it in my headset. Glenmuir, of course, one of the schools that have won the Da Costa Cup on multiple occasions. Certainly there are schools that have won more than them. But they are seventh in the ranking, with 3 wins, Glenmuir High. And they have done well in the Ben Francis Cup, 6 titles. So they are tied for first with Ben Francis title, Ben Francis Cup titles. Stets and Cornwall College are the teams with the 6 titles. Brandon Wallace. As experienced as Wallace, is a part of the team from last year as well. Here's Gordon. Gordon is trying to thread the final ball through the defense. Was broken up. They still have time. Glenmuir have been affected by the offside trap on numerous occasions. Johnson here on the end of this one. DeAndre Johnson still through on goal. Johnson still with the ball. Johnson gets it through into the back of the net. Hugh Sean Grant. DeAndre Johnson finally gets one. And the 8-goal man moves in the goal scoring charts as well. And this is a mauling. Easy Street, Javier Grant, and the team of defenders. Yeah, they were sleeping there. Yeah, that's the app. That's a look at that goal. Download the Sportsmax app today. Get it on the Google Play or the Apple App Store and follow all the action of schoolboy football. It's all free on the app. You can keep abreast of the scores and the actions as well. Here's Moran Bay. Thompson was trying to cause some damage there. But O'Shane Nation has seen enough of the first half. A half that has been dominated by Glenmuir. Captain led the way with 2. He had 3 assists and a goal to contribute as well. DeAndre Johnson had some problems beating the offside trap as well. But it's really been a dominant performance from Glenmuir on this, their home turf, showing the quality they've had. And Andrew Peart and company, they must be a very relaxed bunch. Moran Bay, they'll have a lot to consider on the long way home, punctuated by road construction and all, and they are a team under construction. It's halftime at Glenmuir. Glenmuir 5, Moran Bay 0. Stick and stay with us, more to come.
Which team are the best and I go better than the rest? And if your team beat your chest, it's a schoolboy football. A team could rise and a team could fall, but you never will know until the whistle blows. So run, come enjoy the show. It's a schoolboy.
UEFA Champions League on Sportsmax 2. FC Barcelona versus Shakhtar Donetsk live Wednesday, 11:45 in Jamaica, 12:45 in the rest of the Caribbean. Also, Paris Saint-Germain versus AC Milan, Wednesday, 2 p.m., 3 in the rest of the Caribbean, also in Sportsmax 2. Getting ready for second half action in this return leg second round feature in the Issa da Costa Cup. Glenmuir hosting Moran Bay. Glenmuir with 5 goals in the first half. 8-0 in aggregate, they lead. And let's see how they can finish off this one in the final 45 minutes of play. still being addressed by their coaching staff. Still with Dane Brown there. Adding his voice to that of Andrew Peart in ensuring the charges from Glenmuir Road keep their hopes in the Da Costa Cup alive. Llewellyn Brown, he's digging the earth, trying to find a new foundation. It's hard to find foundation with water, though. Substitution being made by Glenmuir. Jason White exiting the field. Second of action in this matchup. So Nairn Allen would have also come on for Tajon Cummings. So two changes made at the half for Glenmuir. Here they come now. Looks to be Allen on the ball. They get a corner kick there. Taken short. Here it comes now. Still in a dangerous position. Booted out by Moran Bay only as far as Francis. He was trying to thread through a ball, but that was broken up. Wallace connecting with Ramdial. Here's Brandon Wallace. It's a free kick for Moran Bay, taken by Goldburn. Call going against Ramon Francis. Referee Nation there giving the marker for 10 yards away from the kick. Kick is in a dangerous position. If they have great strikers of the ball, of course. Have seen some long-range shots. This one comes in. And oh, just off the upright. Glenmuir speared by the hand of the goalkeeper and the upright as well. And as we're talking about good strikes, it certainly was one. Moran Bay almost getting their time on the score sheet as well. Just off the upright. Here's Rowe. And that head was in the way for Sean Rowe trying to get another goal to his 7th for the season thus far. By the look of it, I thought that the goalkeeper Antoine Gooden had gotten a hand to it, but it was only off the post. They have another corner, they take it, and Gooden gets up trying to convert. At that occasion was Thompson, just after an attempted acrobatic finish was foiled. But Glenmuir speared. Moranbe looking a bit sprightly early in the second half. Call goes their way. DeAndre Johnson there brought down. Saunders plays through Johnson. Johnson barging down the right-hand flank in the area. Johnson guts it across. Easy finish. A tap-in for the substitute, Nyron Allen. You won't get it much easier than that. 6-0 after 50 minutes of play. And Nyron Allen moves from 3 to 4 on the goal scoring chart. And it came through this man, barging down the right-hand flank. Aurel Miller did well just to flick it back to Nyron Allen. And the substitute able to get himself on the score sheet. And literally, Moranbe in sixes and perhaps sevens. Here they come. Coleman goes all the way to Gooden. Showing composure there, Gooden, but final pass would have let him down. Here's Goldburn from Moranbe. Haven't been really able to string together any meaningful passes. As Moranbe, of course, they have that one shot on target. Make that 2 now since the second half. Here's Glenmuir still pushing forward. The high line might be the undoing once more of Moranbe, but that was broken up. They still have chance. Glenmuir, Allen trying to be a menace to Golding. Golding does well to turn away from danger, but he goes into trouble. Here's Gord now, the opposite number. He was fouled. Confirmation of Nyron Allen's goal tally. Lorraine Watson there on your screen with the arm brace. He's warming up at the moment. Moranbe making a change. Shamoy Graham coming on for Dyron Williams. Here's a shot from distance. Spilled by the keeper. And the follow-up is good from Glenmuir. And another substitute gets his name on the score sheet, Tevin Ramdial. Sixes, then sevens. 10-0 on aggregate now for Glenmuir. And again, you won't find it much easier than that. The swing on the ball there being the undoing of Javier Grant. And Jaheim Hall couldn't hold off the short man from converting from inside the penalty. the 6-yard box, I beg your pardon. So yeah, Glenmuir on Easy Street. Perhaps I really should say Easier Street. It's been easy all afternoon from the second minute of play. Moran Bay trying to get some passes together, but that's broken up. Allen now with the pace. Runs away from the man, sends it across, and at the end of it, R.L. Miller gets a second on the afternoon. It's a hammering, an absolute demolition job. He started it, and he adds an eighth on the afternoon, Llewellyn Brown. What could be on his mind? Wonderful delivery, and Miller really did well. Naren Allen with the assist there. Timed his run well, did R.L. Miller. And it's really been their afternoon. Now the pressure continues to pile as the sunlight's intensity increases here at Glenmuir Road. Losing possession again. Here's Miller turning in the center circle. Gordon to Wallace. The return ball to Gordon. He's onside. Kyle Gordon. Can this be the hat trick? Gordon. He was really looking for that. The referee saw nothing in it, and it was really just a clash of bodies. Glenmuir, though, still trying, but it's with Goldburn, his pass broken up. Saunders trying to do the defensive work there, gives up a throw in. Beautiful sunlight coming on out. 6 goals for R.L. Miller this season, as you see there on your screen. Shadows being cast by the trees on far side of the field. From danger. Wallace trying to switch the play there. Struck Kyle Gordon on the head, and of course there's a concussion protocol. Any such injury would cause the game to be halted by the referee. Checking if he's in his full bearings, if he responds to commands. He's been brought off the field. He's loving the coverage. of Sportsmax, I'm sure. They are loving the shade. So just off your screen, Kyle Gordon being attended to. Ball played back to Glenn Muir as they had possession before that injury, but they regain it now. R.L. Miller goes in chase. Burst of speed. R.L. Miller in the area. Brings it back for Allen. Has to turn back. Swings it in. Turns. Laying it off for Ram Dayal. His shot blocked. Opportunity spurned. Here comes Moran Bay now. Trying to release Rowe. Gooden came out with alacrity to avert the danger. And they resume their attacking thrust quickly. Does Glenn Muir. Headley and Wallace now will try to release Allen, or he turns it back to Headley. Allen releases Saunders. Good challenge from Goldburn there. The number eight for Moran Bay has been perhaps one of the standout players. Moran Bay. Here's Allen. Gooden there, almost getting himself in all sorts of problems. Free kick wanted to Moran Bay. Hilton Brown there being fouled on that occasion. Johnson has been so instrumental in, especially the early goals, was Johnson. Beautiful ball. Johnson releasing it for Allen. That was a bit too central. Hilton Brown making no mistake there, giving the throw in. Allowing Glenn Muir the opportunity to push forward with their back line as well. Headley. Wallace. Headley trying to connect with Saunders. Xavier Grant in goal. Mopping up easily, but that spilled. Still with Glenmuir now. Playing with a bit of composure, not hasty in their build-up. Giving away possession there through a throw-in. Interception. R.L. Miller on the end of it. R.L. Miller. Just going to connect it, Goldwood, or to his teammate, Nairn Allen. Give Moran Bay the opportunity to play it out for a throw-in. Kyle Gordon indicating that he's not in the best physical condition to continue. Of course, that concussion would have been a problem. Tavon Coleman being given the captain's armband. Well, love the maturity of Kyle Gordon to recognize that it really wasn't worth it to push through any pain and to put his health first. Of course, they will have tougher encounters to come. So quite a few changes being made. Orrin Watson, the national under 17 representative for Jamaica, makes his way to the field of play. The opening encounter of their campaign, he had some some injury concerns, of course, a dislocated wrist, as the coach would have mentioned in the pre-game show. So Tayshaun Rowe replaces Kyle Gordon. And Arain Watson comes in for Akeem Saunders. Let's see how play will continue with these changes. Ramdial to Wallace. Lovely ball for Miller. Miller on the charge, holding off his man. Turns, lifted in the area. Only coming to Golding. Golding now going into traffic, but it's with Goldburn. Tries to connect with Thompson. Thompson loses possession there. Brandon Wallace doing enough. Naren Allen, Ramdial, Coleman, Headley. Central Elizabeth Technical High School. Here's Golding for Moranbe. Golding! Perhaps their best opportunity all afternoon. And Golding didn't have the golden touch at all. Firing it high over the frame of the goal. Oh, that was a glorious opportunity. Here they come, Glenmuir. Johnson did very well to get that one on target. But good defensive work from Jaheim Hall. Played it out for a corner kick. Corner kick for Glenmuir. Headley with the delivery. Francis stripped of possession. Good defensive work that from Glenmuir, but they lose possession. Thompson now on the ball. Fix. Sends it across to Golding. Only goes to Gooden. He releases to Allen. Watson on the ball. Connecting with Ramdia. Watson has pace. Gets in on behind. And that's a red card shown to the number 8. From Moranbe, Antonio Goldburn. Already had a yellow card from the first half, conceding the penalty which Kyle Gordon had converted. This time he's shown a straight red. And yeah. Goldburn will make the task a bit easier for Glenmuir. Of course, on account of the numbers game. Let's see if they can make this resulting free kick count. Xavier Grant hasn't had the best of days between the sticks. Three players standing behind it. Johnson, Wallace, and Headley. Wallace moves off, so does Headley. DeAndre Johnson, can he convert? Perhaps in another sport. To make bench of the surface here at Glenmuir High School. The grass coverage is really top class. The field is a bit, the ground is a bit hard, but there is a soft texture to the grass that I'm sure would allow the ball to be played well. It does roll well, as you can see. Here's Allen. He's through. Allen now. And the surgical precision that I'm sure Andrew Peart would want, not really being executed. Allen, of course, I believe should have shot first time rather than going for the pass. Here's Johnson with Wallace. Nyron Allen swings it across for Orain Watson. Watson lays it up for Johnson. Johnson with the shot. Tayshaun Rowe is on the end of it. He took a touch too many, giving Moranby the opportunity to play it out for a throw-in. Glenmuir in possession. Here's Johnson. Again, not as sharp as they really should be in front of goal. Glenmuir. They come again, the shot from distance, deflected out for a corner kick. Certainly can see the youthfulness on Tevin Randiel's face. It's a corner kick for Glenmuir. Brandon Wallace standing behind this one. Lifts it up in the area. Moranby able to clear. Nyron Allen did well there to play it off Golding for a throw-in for Glenmuir. Watson. Randiel spreads it further wide to Francis. Good ball played across now. Lorraine Watson was the target, but too much on that one. Javier Grant able to collect. He spreads it forward. Easily handled by the defense of Glenmuir, hitting it on to the keeper who plays it out. They recycle now. Allen. Quite a few of the players are offside. They're not showing the kind of alertness to get back onside. Wallace. Randiel. Aaron Millen doesn't have the pace to get to that one. Moran Bay in possession through the keeper. Of course, two other matches being played today in the Da Costa Cup second round. Stets leading Irwin 2-0, 3-0 on aggregate. B.B. Koch and Paul Bogle also being contested today. We'll give you an update on that one. Watson was onside. His first touch really let him down. I'm sure he really didn't believe he was onside. Indeed, he was waiting to see if the offside flag would have been raised. Orain Watson was so prolific last year. And to date, we have been really robbed of all of his excellence in front of goal based on injury. Here's Allen. Ramdia. Miller plays it back to Francis. Coleman has it now. Headley makes use of Gooden. Brandon Wallace. As Headley uses him. Johnson released Watson, but he was offside. So Gerard Marsili has a sideline report. Gerard, what do you have for us?
Thanks a lot, Dean. Well, this one is coming from the Glenmuir High School side. And Orion Watson, the number 9, you can see him with a cast on his arm. He's not fully fit. Of course, we saw him go down with an injury early in this season. But Coach Andrew Peart, who brought him on in the second half, really wants Orion to stay true to his number 9 position. Earlier when he came on, he was going a little bit too deep into his half because he wanted to play defense and support defensively. But Coach Peart wants him to concentrate on playing that true number 9 position and to beat that offside trap, stay as close as possible to the middle or just on the shoulders of the two central defenders. That's why you see him looking around so much, because as soon as he doesn't see one, he looks to see where he is, and if he can find the other one, then he can stay true to the offside position. That's when he tries to calculate whether he is offside or onside. That's why he doesn't run behind the ball if he doesn't see both defenders in front of him. So yeah, that's Orion Watson, Coach Andrew Peart, with strict instructions for him, and yeah, proven out to be a little bit fruitful for him. Can he score? We'll see.
All right, thank you so much, Gerard, for that sideline report. As we see some more substitutions being made by Glenmuir. Watson coming on for Aurel Miller, the two-goal man this afternoon. Here's Headley. Allen, another substitute. Releasing Devonny Gordon. Gordon gets by one. Good challenge, firm challenge there from Jaim Hall. Corner kick for Glenmuir. Lifted up. Header on, but it's over the mark by Time now for the Sportsmax app moment, brought to you by the Sportsmax app. Came from this sequence of play. Double save by the goalkeeper, Javier Grant. Especially this one from the shot from Cummins, who really had an eye for goal, an eye for glory on that one, making himself big. Javier Grant, the Sportsmax app moment of the game. Of course, so much action you can get on the Sportsmax app. You can follow all the action in schoolboy football here in the island of Jamaica for free on the Sportsmax app. Download it on the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. And of course, so many other sporting adventures you can go on. You have a Champions League, La Liga, the Jamaica Premier League. Yeah, they all reside on the home of champions. Get the Sportsmax app. Devoni Gordon on the ball. Showing a bit too much and loses possession. Ramdia. Headley was under a bit of pressure there from Golding. Ramdale trying to thread that one through. Gets to his man. Orin Watson now released. Watson. He's brought down again. And another red card being flashed, this time to Jaheim Hall. And a Moranbe, they're down to 9 men. Oh, it's misery for Moranbe. Maureen Watson using his pace there. And Jaheim Hall. In the circumstances, I think he should have just let him go through. Llewellyn Brown. So much on his mind. What's on the mind of Javier Grant in goal for Moranbe? What's on the mind of Denzel Watson and Brandon Wallace behind this free kick? Wallace looks favored to take it. Steps up. Wallace. Skies that one high. Repeat there on screen. We'd love to know his thoughts on the play of Glenmuir ever since going up, especially 6-0. The intensity in my mind has died down, but some of the key players who really kept them ticking, perhaps most notably their captain, has gone off. They have been able to hold Moranbe at bay. He's on the Moranbe bench. Well, their spirit doesn't appear to be broken. That's good. St. Mary High, they have a gargantuan task tomorrow against Garvey Maseo. I'm happy I'm not on commentary duties for that game. St. Mary High, of course, being colors that I donned, the under 16 level. Garvey Maseo doing the business against my alma mater. Here's Glenmuir. Naren Allen lifts it up, trying to find Watson. Moranbe tries to go the other way. outnumbered is Morant Bay, and they run into traffic. Here's Devonny Gordon. Still Gordon. Tashaun Rowe was waiting for that one, but the injury to Golding brings a halt to the proceedings as medical staff of Morant Bay being brought to assist Richard Golding of Morant Bay. So as it stands, we can give you a picture of the quarterfinal groupings based on the seedings in the round of 32. Of course, Glenmuir and Stets practically confirming their places in the quarterfinals of the competition. And those groupings would have been predetermined based on the seedings. So we'll give you that in a short while. Here's Rowe for Glenmuir. Gets in the box. Yeah, that was poor from Rowe. Hurry blows in the favor of Morant Bay. Watson. Beautiful ball for Allen. He wished he did better than that. Stretching for that one. Had a bit more time than perhaps he thought he did. Here they come again. Glenmuir with Allen. Trying to get by one. Good defensive work that from Thompson. Coleman doing well there. The heart of Glenmuir's defense. Ball for Devonny Gordon, the number seven. Cues it up for Rowe. Rowe draws it further wide. Still with Glenmuir through Ramdiel. Headley plays it to Gordon. Watson, yeah, that Rowe. Rowe is in through on goal, but good defensive work that time from the defender, Javane Brown. Sportsmax app. They're loving the action. Here's a corner kick lifted in, and the header is in on goal. Oren Watson, the number 9. She loves it. He loves it. Glenmuir Nation loves it. Flagrants. Color red, they say. It's 9 for the number 9. And they're loving the action. Here's another look at it. He went up well to meet that delivery from the corner kick. He's loving the action. Oren Watson gets goal number 5 this season. Well, the sixth former who was interviewed by Gerard did say 10 goals or maybe even 12. Well, he'll get 12 on aggregate. O'Shea Nation has seen enough, calls time on this one. Glenmuir comprehensively dispatching Moran Bay in their return leg second round fixture in the Issa da Costa Cup, and they march through to the semi-final round of the competition. Kyle Gordon had to be substituted. Anil Hendley, he had a great game in the heart of defense. Ramdial came on as a substitute and scored as well. And Moran Bay, they had a gargantuan task from the start of the 90 minutes. And with every minute played, it only got worse as Glenmuir ironed out any kink they had and steamrolled their opposition. Llewellyn Brown will have a lot to consider as he was called back to his alma mater to coach them after returning from overseas. Confirmation of the full-time score. Glenmuir 9, Moran Bay 0. This in the Issa da Costa Cup. Here are the full-time highlights in minute number 2. It started. This ball was played in by Kyle Gordon. DeAndre Johnson on the end of it, lifted in the area. And R.L. Miller was on hand to guide it home. The first goal of the afternoon. At that time, R.L. Miller had only scored 5 goals this season. It would continue for Glenmuir. And Kyle Gordon converted the penalty with consummate ease. It would continue. And here we saw DeAndre Johnson again playing it through for Kyle Gordon, and he fired home with aplomb. Another look at it. It was really excellently done. Here are the full-time match statistics. Glenmuir had 15 shots on target from 29 attempts. Moran Bay had 1 shot on target from 9 attempts. 12 fouls to Glenmuir, 10 to Moran Bay. A yellow card apiece. 2 red cards are shown to Moran Bay. Glenmuir, they had 8 offsides. They really weren't running the lines well. 9 corners, 6 of them to Glenmuir. Javier Grant in goal for Moran Bay had to make 7 saves and Glenmuir had 80% of the possession to go with 9 of the goals. They win 9-0 on the day, 12-0 on aggregate. Glenmuir, they go through to the quarterfinal round. We have the Sportsmax man of the match. He's with Gerard on the field.
Yeah, thank you so much, Dean. Yeah, of course, 4 assists to go with 1 goal. You're the man of the match, DeAndre.
All right, thank you.
Congratulations to you. Well played. Let me ask you a couple questions though, before you go. How would you rate this performance? Is it your best for the season?
Well, I would say that because I got 4 assists and a goal, so yes, definitely.
Yeah, well, of course, Glenmuir surging forward. Now you're into the round of 16. What are you looking to go from here?
Well, we just have to stick to the coach's instruction and go on as far as possible and also get a chance to hold the Da Costa Cup.
Yeah, what are those instructions, though? Tell me a little bit.
Well, you always have to stay focused, be aggressive when you go out there, put our chances, and just stay focused.
All right. Well, we did look focused today. Congratulations to you. You're off to the round of 16.
Right,
yeah, that was it. Sportsmax, man of the match, DeAndre Johnson. Now, Coach Llewellyn Brown, we say goodbye to Morant Bay from here now, but when you look back at the season, what are some of the positives that came out of it?
The positiveness is that even we are down, we still fight. We're still fighting and fighting. So the things that I know, we got to go back and we got to work harder, and we know that next season will be much better.
Yeah, well, your captain was on a red card suspension, wasn't able to play today. How much did that hurt the team's chances for you?
Well, what we did, all players can play in 2 or 3 different positions. So what we did, we just filter our next player playing.
Yeah, well, you did say that this is a program that is building for Morant Bay.
Yeah, from 2014.
So you've been able to get out of the group this time. How far do you think you can get eventually? And how soon?
Okay, all right.
You see yourself in the semifinals sometime soon, maybe.
Yeah, because we sit down, management sit down, and we plan. Said, this year we have to go to the second round to see how it feel. What is it? What is it about? So we can just go back, and we'll know what to work on, and next year much better.
All right, Coach. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
It was nice having you. We'll see you next season. Coach Andrew Peart, now we have a chat with him from Glenmuir High. Coach Peart, a result that, of course, you will be happy with in terms of going forward to the next round. However, do you think that the team's performance on the pitch was paramount? Was it the best?
Yeah, I think so, based on the fight that the opponents brought to us. I must comment Morant Bay High School, though, that even whilst the score was going up, they were still competing. And that's a good sign of a program that's growing. So it's good for us that we are through to the next round and we look forward to our opponents there.
9-0, were you expecting that scoreline?
A little bit, yeah. based on the first leg and the quality chances that we created this game.
Yeah, when you look back at your players though, who are some of the players that you thought could have, well, really stood out in this game and shone brightly for your team?
For our team? I think our defenders did well to limit the number of chances that Morant Bay created. I thought Brandon Wallace, number 3, and Tavon Coleman, number 20, did really well there as well.
All right, Coach. Well, you're tuned to the next round. We'll see you then. And all the best for you.
Thank you.
YouTube. It's a man in cup on Sportsmax YouTube. Kingston Technical versus St. Andrew Technical live Wednesday, 2:20 p.m., 3:20 in the rest of the Caribbean. And that's the first of a doubleheader. Campion College, they play Kingston College, 4:30 p.m., 5:30 in the rest of the Caribbean. The Costa Cup also on the home of champions and Scene TV, Central High. They host William Nib in the second leg of the second round fixture, Wednesday, 12:30 p.m., 1:30 in the rest of the Caribbean. And Edwin Allen play McGrath live Wednesday, 3 p.m., 4 in the rest of the Caribbean. So 4 matches for your viewing pleasure tomorrow. It's on the home of champions, Yeah, that's how we do it. Glenmuir, 9-0 winners of Moran Bay, 12-0 on aggregate. In the return leg fixture in the second round of the Da Costa Cup, they progress to the next round. It's been easy street for them. Flagrants, their flag flying high.
Yo, Issa, high school boy football, look this season. People, them ready, you know.
All right then, pick up, man in cup. Oliver, your shield, you make we link up. We watch the Champions Cup, Ben Francis, Water Cup. Which team are win the championship this season?
Yo, Issa,
for one dive at school, I go finish the league and beat now. Which youth, I go collect the golden boot and be the favorite for the people.
Yo, Issa,
missy fans are roll out all about the flag pan vehicle. Looking at the crowd, but loan and support us from school and community too. People nothing at the stand, some a listen pan rate, some a watch it on TV too. Country and town unite for one reason.
Issa, schoolboy football.